Another team that I wanted to talk about, another game I wanted to talk about. I wanted to talk about Ohio State and Nebraska. Because my question for Nebraska is pretty simple. Are you a pro or do you spar? I mean, I know who Ohio State is. You know, that's Roy Jones Jr. That is they gotta move to live. You know, I know who that is. I know that Ohio State is in it to win it. I know that that's a pro. If they don't win, they don't eat. I know how they're going to respond to a loss. I've seen it. I know the fan base. I know the type of player. I know the type of coach. They're grinders. I'm a grinder. Hell, my goodness. But they're talented grinders. And they took a one-point loss to Oregon, and all they've seen is other people say, okay, now we know you're not that good. You paid all this money for that roster. You're not that good. As if getting paid somehow makes you a little less capable. As if being somewhat well-fed and not hungry means you just don't want it as bad. Well, now they took the loss. Now Oregon gets that. We're the number one ranking that we would not give to Ohio State, not near one time this year. Wouldn't do it. Now you got to go take it out on Nebraska. Nebraska got to figure out whether or not they want to be a professional. You know, look, there are all sorts of talented amateurs out there. There really are. They good. I enjoy watching amateurs do the job. I really do. I like watching amateurs fight. I like seeing promise. But take that headgear off, and you get to find out what you made of. I got two collapsed knuckles. I got one over here and one over here. You know? Because at one point, I forgot how to throw a punch. Both hands. I also get to find out what it's like to get punched in the face. I get to find out what it is like to get knocked on my behind and then hear my head hit the canvas and whether or not I still want to do this. And no, getting hit, nobody want to get hit. It sucks. I hate getting hit. Matter of fact, I wish I could get knocked out when I would get hit, because if you get knocked out, you don't feel nothing. Like, you're just gone. Lights go out because your brain goes, hey, we're going to turn the lights out so that you don't kill us because you stupid being in this ring right now. But you get hit, all you feel is hurt and pain. And hurt and pain turns to anger. And if you don't know how to harness that anger, you throw bad punches. You know, if you don't know how to keep your composure and keep yourself under control, your footwork goes to crap. And you open yourself up, and all of a sudden, body, head, and you down again. I want to see what Nebraska looks like going up against what I know is a professional in Ohio State. I want to see some get back. You got any of that in you, Nebraska? I mean, some of y'all ain't got it. You know, we ain't got to name names on this one, but some of y'all ain't got it. You know, you have been in the position to be bowl eligible in the Matt Rhule era 6 times now, and you have failed 6 times. You got embarrassed by Indiana in Bloomington. You have lost 26 consecutive games against top 25 opponents, and oh yeah, Ohio State is most definitely a top 25 opponent. No, nobody's picking you in this game. No, nobody. Nobody's picking you. Hell, Nebraska fans got a hard time picking you. What are you going to do about it? Are you going to play as if you got nothing left to lose? As if you got nothing left? Because that was always the person that I wanted to become when we had to go fight. Am I afraid of what might happen in this thing? Or do I not give a damn? Because if I don't give a damn, I'm probably going to win. Probably going to win. Because I can't go back. Nah. I can't go back home with a loss. I can't do that. What if you decided to take this Aristea that I got on my arm right here and make that your war cry? You know what an Aristea is? Aristea is a gift. It's a gift. And it's not up to you. It's not about effort. Even though I'm all about effort, it's not about effort. It's certainly not about talent. But you got to have effort to get it. You don't have to have talent to get it. Effort's just not going to give it to you. It doesn't guarantee you a damn thing. So in the heat of battle, you're going after it. You decided, I got nothing left to lose here. I will go vanquish this enemy or I will die on this battlefield. You made that commitment. Whatever happens after that, happens after that. If you're Norse, maybe the Valkyries come get you. Maybe they don't. You've decided, no, I will go out on my terms if that's what it has to happen. And then Athena can look down at you and she can decide to give you this gift. She can decide to give you an Aristeia, which is one time granted ability to vanquish the opponent in front of you for all time. You get to just destroy them because she recognizes the sacrifice that you had made. Not one you're willing to make. You did make it. You dead on the battlefield. You're done. She brings you back and says, I like you, mortal. Go handle your business. Or she could say, hell nah, I ain't giving you damn thing and keep walking. And you just dead there now. Are you willing to make that sacrifice? Because if not, maybe don't go to the shoe on Saturday. Maybe stay home, watch some television, you know. Get you a lifestyle job. Get you one of these jobs where people don't call you names in comments, where people don't ask for you to be fired, where people don't want to see you play anymore because you are making them physically ill, where people blame you for the bad day that they have or the bad week that they have or the bad season they have. Maybe you want a regular job. Maybe you don't want to play in Nebraska. Maybe you don't want to coach in Nebraska. I can't answer that question for you. I'm doing this one. I got a job that's similar to yours. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to be here. But are you? Are you going to try to man up against Jeremiah Smith? Is that what you're going to do? Is your defensive line going to get home against Will Howard? Are you going to stuff Quinshon Judkins and Travion Henderson at the line of scrimmage? Huh? Are you going to be the wide receiver that finally turns into a deep threat for Dylan Raiola? Are you going to hold on to the football when you see Cody Simon throw his helmet at it? Are you going to high point the ball against Caleb Downs? You got any of that in you? There was a time when Nebraska did. There was a time when I feared Nebraska. I was afraid of what Nebraska might do to Oklahoma. I'm not afraid anymore. Mm-mm. You just Nebraska. You Big Ten Nebraska. That's who you are. You Big Ten Nebraska. Just kind of look out of place. And every time we expect you to be great, to go be great, and we want you to go be great in the worst way, you do what you did against Indiana. Or at least that's what it's been lately. One day it's got to stop, man. I don't know what it's going to take. I don't know who's going to get it done. But I do know we all can't wait to see you become the program that we knew you to be in the 1970s, the 1980s, the 1990s, and the early 2000s. Find that program. Find a way to relish the gift of being a Nebraska Cornhusker, playing football at one of the most storied and coolest programs on the face of the earth. I sometimes think it is trite for people to say, what's your why? My why is I got bills to pay. You know what I'm saying? My why is I got to keep the lights on. But maybe that's not trite for Nebraska. Maybe you need to find out what the hell it is that you're playing for. Because if it's just you, you're going to get beat. You're going to get beat to hell. They're going to stomp a mud hole in you and walk you dry. But if you find a way to play for many, then you become legion. Find a way to become many. Go talk to somebody in a grocery store who's got a Nebraska hat on. Go to the bank teller. Go to the bowling alley. Go find somebody who's going to tell you their Nebraska story. And keep those close, man. Carry that into the shoe, and then we'll see what happens. See what happens.